Hello friends, welcome to this next video on measure theory. Till now what we have seen, we had this box of all the big measurable sets, okay, and we have seen what are the things inside this box. So we have found that phi and r, they are in the set. We have found that if a set belongs to this box, then its complement is also in the box. And the last thing we have seen that sets without a Lebesgue measure 0, they are in this box, right? Now we would like to know, what about the sets? What about the sets with non-zero outer measure? Okay, with m star non-zero. We have to look at these sets where m star is not equal to 0. We have to see what about these sets. Okay, so before searching for the answer to this question, okay, we would like to prove some other things. The first thing is, we would like to prove that this box is actually a sigma algebra. This box is a sigma algebra. Okay. That will help us in proving, in searching the answer for this question which we are looking for. So first thing which we have to prove is that we have to prove that this box is a sigma algebra. So we would like to know what is the definition of a sigma algebra. So I will just write down here what is the definition of a sigma algebra. So sigma algebra is basically a collection of sets. Sigma algebra is a collection of sets which satisfy following properties. What are the properties? The first property is that both r and phi should belong to that collection. Okay, I'll call that collection as A, capital A. So A is said to be a sigma algebra if both r and phi, they are the member of A. Second is, if a set E belongs to A, then E complement belongs to A and vice versa. Okay, and the last one is, if a countable collection E1, E2, E3 and so on, they are in A, then union of EIs from 1 to infinity should also be in A. If these three properties are satisfied, 1, 2, 3, if these three properties are satisfied, then we say that A, that collection, is a sigma algebra, right? Now we would like to prove that our box which we have started with, we would like to know prove that this box of all Lebesgue measurable sets is a sigma algebra. This is our task, right? Now you can clearly see that we have already proved this first property. We have already proved that both r and phi are inside our box, and we have already proved that if a set E is in the box, then its complement is also in the box and vice versa. So first two properties we have already proved. Now we are left with this third property which we have to prove, right? But here you have this countable collection, right? So I will start with the proof of this property. But before actually proving this property, in this video we will prove a mild property. So what is that property, right? So that property is, if you have a finite collection, that means you have this E1, E2, EN. These are the N sets, okay, belongs to the collection A. Then union of these sets, I from 1 to infinity, that is also in A, right? So we have to prove that a finite union of Lebesgue measurable sets is a Lebesgue measurable set. Here, what is A? A is our set of all Lebesgue measurable sets. Set of that box we are talking, that here A is that box. Set of all Lebesgue measurable sets. So basically we want to prove that, we can write it in the words as finite union of Lebesgue measurable sets is a Lebesgue measurable set. This is what we have to prove. This is our next direction. We will prove that finite union of Lebesgue measurable sets is a Lebesgue measurable set. But you should have a clear direction why we are doing it. We'll just recall that we have to prove this. Okay, this is what we are going to prove in the next video. But why we are going to prove it? Because we want to prove that our set, our box, is a sigma algebra. And why we want to prove that our box is a sigma algebra? We want to prove that our box is a sigma algebra because that will help us in knowing what about the sets with positive outer measure. whether those sets are Lebesgue measurable sets or not. Thank you.